being aggressive, yeah. 13 shots. What was your bounce at?
I was just calmer. I don't know. I was coming into the game. I was real calm. I was just, you know, like, I knew we had to get a win. We were on two game skid. So I just knew we had to play well. And they were giving me looks early. And coaches is always like before the game, you can reiterate, like, be aggressive in transition. Be aggressive, be aggressive. So, nobody stopped me when I was going, so I just kept going.
When you look at it, like the box score from NC State the other night, I'm not sure how many minutes you played, but I think you took two shots. Do you look at that and think, man, I can't do that. I need to do more of that?
I mean, no, I was just, I didn't really look at it anyway. It was just another game. I mean, I was trying to, you know, play good defense on TJ Warren because he's a great player.
Yeah.
So that's where all my energy was going.
Josh, did you guys, I know Coach had mentioned maybe making some adjustments in some tweaks after NC State. Did you guys really change a whole lot, or was it just kind of, you guys maybe play a little bit better and maybe just kind of what happened?
No, we just put a little bit of different tweaks in different plays. You know, how they start, because teams were scouting us and, you know, figuring this out. So just changed little stuff.
You scored, I think, six in your last two games to come out, and I think have 12 or 14 in the first half. But, I mean, was it good to have a good game offensively for you?
Yeah, it felt nice. I was glad we were winning at the end. And then I was hyped about Derek's dunk. So that was pretty much the big thing in the locker room at halftime.
Wouldn't a lot of guys, you said you were really calm tonight, despite knowing that y'all had to win. Wouldn't a lot of guys be nervous in that situation, like knowing you have to win?
Yeah, but I mean, I'm the type of guy, I don't really let pressure bother me at all. Nothing really bothers me. That's kind of cruise. So usually I like get all hyped up before a game or whatever, but today I was just like, normal. I was just chilling today.
Was Derek calling too, I guess?
I didn't really talk to him before the game, so I don't know.
What got into him?
I don't know. He just stayed ready all year, and he played a great game for us.
Josh, what does it say about him? Is it, you know, team? I mean, you know how tough it's got to be if you're not playing to, you know, keep that competitive edge. I mean, pretty impressive for him to come out and do that tonight.
Yeah, it was big. I mean, he's played well in practice all year, so I was glad to see him, you know, come out and play well for us.
Have you noticed a difference in practice the last week or so?
Probably last month, yeah. He's definitely been playing a lot tougher. He's been hitting a lot more shots in practice. I think he's been in the gym a lot more lately. I'm just glad that he's, you know, just got his edge back.
You said, talked about how Coach Martin really told you to be aggressive and reiterated. How much more adamant was he to be aggressive this game as opposed to the rest of the season?
I don't know. He just called me back to talk to him before a tip, and he was just like, he tapped me. He was like, be aggressive. And I was like, all right. He was like, no, really, be aggressive. I was like, all right. So, more so than other games.
So, a lot of that is on you guys. Do you guys run many set plays, or is it pretty much just the offense and the opportunities that come with it?
Oh, we run plays, but we huddled up before a tip, and we haven't really been running this year. And Coach always tells us to get out and run. So before tip, we're like, if anybody gets it, we're just out. We're taking off. And we're like, told Antonio, if me or Jordy get the ball, then run, and we'll bring it up and just get it up as fast as we could. And they just weren't getting back fast enough.
And he said, Coach, we asked him about it, if you guys are going faster. He said, I always want to go fast. If we're not going fast, it's the guard's fault. Is that true? That can't be totally true.
I think it's everybody's fault. We're not going fast. But
no, but is he really always want to go fast? I mean, is he always on you guys? I mean, does he come in after games like, we should have pushed it more here, should have pushed it more there?
Before games, he's always like, run, run. But, I mean, if it's not working, then he'll tell us to slow down.
And be aggressive just on the whole team, or you specifically before the game?
Well, I just remember him pulling me back to the sideline before the team and just, you know, kept telling me to be aggressive and start out aggressive.
How big is it for this team to score 80 points with Jordan scoring less than 10? Maybe some people wouldn't have wondered if that was even possible, I guess, you know, some nights.
I guess it shows how balanced we can be. I mean, we got different guys that can go out any night. I mean, Derek came out with a double-double night, and that was out of nowhere. So, I mean, it just shows how deep our bench is and how talented we can be.
It seemed like that 13-0 run to start the second half kind of, you know, slammed the door on them. What were you guys doing during that to kind of pull away?
Just running, just getting the ball up and running. And people were getting to the rim in transition. We weren't pulling it back out and slowing it down. Everybody was in attack mode.
And did you feel like, I mean, you needed to do that? Because you threw a pretty good run on in the first half, and they didn't go away. I mean, you get good because you doubled it digitally. Did you feel like you needed to hit them again coming out of halftime?
Definitely. We were only up 11 going into the half. And we said that in the locker room after we, you know, calmed down a little bit. And we were just like, me and Jordy were like, we're only up 11 points, and we should be up by more than that. So came out second half and jumped on it.
I know you don't want to shoot a lot.